Steve here from Photoshop Essentials. So Adobe just released its newest generative AI features in the Photoshop beta, and the one we'll look at here, called Generate Image, can create an entire AI image from scratch using Adobe Firefly. It's basically the text-to-image module from the Firefly website, but now embedded directly into Photoshop. It even brings over most of the same features, including the options to match the style of a reference image and add different effects. And it uses the new Firefly Image 3 model for better quality and higher resolution. So let's see how it works. For now, Generate Image is only available in the Photoshop beta. But if you have a Creative Cloud subscription, you can open your Creative Cloud desktop app, choose Apps over on the left, then choose Beta at the top, and look for the Photoshop beta. If it's not yet installed, you'll see an Install button to click on, and once it is installed, click Open. So the first thing we need to do is create a new document. If you're on the home screen, click the New File button, or from Photoshop's main interface, go up to the File menu and choose New. Then in the New Document dialog box, set both the width and height to 2048 pixels, since that's the resolution limit for the new Firefly Image 3 model. Leave all of the other options at the defaults and click Create. I'm going to zoom in on my canvas by going up to the View menu and choosing Fit on Screen. Now, there are three places to find the new Generate Image option. One of them is in the contextual taskbar. I have my taskbar hidden at the moment, so I'll bring it back by going up to the Window menu and choosing Contextual Taskbar down at the bottom. And now we see that Generate Image button. There's also a new Generate Image icon at the bottom of the toolbar. And if you go up to the Edit menu, you'll find Generate Image there as well. But usually you'll just choose it from the taskbar. And this opens the new Generate Image dialog box, which is really the text-to-image module from the Adobe Firefly website, but now is a dialog box directly in Photoshop. The first thing you'll want to do is enter a prompt to describe the image you want to create. If you need some inspiration, you can try out any of the sample images along the right. If you click on one of them, you'll see the prompt that was used to create it. You'll also see the other options that were used, like the content type, the reference image if it had one, and any effects that were applied. We'll look at all of these options in a moment. I'm going to enter my own prompt, and to keep things simple, I'll enter a close-up of a small, colorful bird perched on a branch. And then you'll want to choose a content type. You can choose art for a more creative type of image, or photo for something more photorealistic. I'll go with art. Below that is the style section. And here you can choose a reference image to have Photoshop match its colors and its overall look and feel. And you can add one or more effects to your image. But we can always try different style options after the image is generated. For now, all we really need is our prompt and the content type. So I'll click Generate to see what Photoshop comes up with. And Photoshop needs to send the file over the internet to the Adobe Firefly servers, and it can take 10 to 15 seconds. When it's done, you'll get three initial results to choose from. And this first one doesn't look too bad. Notice in the Layers panel that we have a new generative layer that holds the results, and we can tell it's a generative layer by the icon in its thumbnail. You can try out the other results by clicking their thumbnails in the Properties panel. You can also cycle through them using the left and right arrows in the contextual taskbar. I'm actually going to move my taskbar out of the way so it's not in front of the images. I'll drag it up to the top, and I'll make sure it stays there by clicking the menu icon and choosing Pin Bar Position. If you like one of the results better than the others, you can hover your cursor over its thumbnail, then click the menu icon and choose Generate Similar. And that tells Photoshop to use that result as the base image and generate three more results that are similar to it. But in my case, I'm not sure I like any of them, so I'll delete them by clicking the trash bins. And you can always edit your prompt here in the Properties panel if you want to change something or make it more descriptive, and then click Generate to try again. But what I want to do is keep the same prompt but change the style of the results. And one way to do that is to use a reference image. So I'll click the Edit Reference Image icon here in the Properties panel. By using a reference image, Photoshop can generate new results that match the colors, the lighting, and the whole visual style of that reference image. You can click the Choose Image button if you have your own image you want to use, or you can choose an image from the gallery. And these are the same images you'd find on the Adobe Firefly website, although they're much better organized on the Firefly website. Here, they're all kind of lumped together. So hopefully that will change. I'm going to start by choosing one of the watercolor images, like this one here with the blue flowers. Then I'll click the X to close the dialog box. So with the same prompt and my watercolor image as the style reference, I'll click Generate again. And I get three new results that match that watercolor style. And you can try out as many reference images as you like. Just click the Edit Reference Image icon, and then click the Replace Image button if you want to try out your own image or choose a different one from the gallery. I'm going to scroll down and choose one of the 3D rendered images, like this beach scene with the umbrellas. And then I'll click X to close the dialog box, and I'll click Generate again. And we get three completely different results that match the colors and that 3D style. This third one looks a little odd with the bird's foot, but let's try one more. I'll click Edit Reference Image one last time. And this time I'll scroll down and choose one of the neon lighting images. And then I'll click Generate. And again, we get three completely different results, even though the prompt was the same every time. So the other way to change the style is by adding effects. I'll click the Edit Effects icon in the Properties panel. Now, this is also where you can change the content type. So if I wanted a more photorealistic image, I could switch from art to photo, but I'll leave it where it is. Below that is where we find all of the effects. There's lots to choose from, and they're divided into categories. The popular category shows the effects that are currently most popular, so they'll change over time. And you can add as many effects as you want. And the first one I want is actually here in the popular category, and it's the layered paper effect. But I could also find it under materials. And there it is right there. I'm also going to open the themes category, and I'll scroll down and choose the newspaper effect. So I'm going for a very papery kind of look here. And the last effect I want is under techniques. And it's the double exposure effect, just to see if it helps to blend everything together. If you click on selected, you'll see all of the effects you'll be applying. And you can click on an effect to deselect it if you need to. But I want all three. So now I'm combining my prompt, my reference image, and my three effects. I'll click Generate. And I think that looks really good. We've got the colors from the reference image, the double exposure effect blending things together, and those paper effects in the background. Let's try the second result. And I really like how the edges in this one are all faded. I'll try the third one. And this one looks okay, but I like the other two better. Of course, if I didn't like any of them, I could just click Generate again. But I'm pretty happy with these ones. And there we have it. That's how to generate entire images from scratch using the new Generate Image feature in the latest Photoshop beta. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more Photoshop tutorials. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.